So we're going to do some absolute classic country tonight. My wife, beautiful wife Sheila's here tonight.
Yay.
And our friend so the slide met us, we went down to Canyonville and heard Marty Stewart.
Yeah.
If you're familiar with Marty Stewart. And Slide and I had been talking about doing a set of Harry Nilsson songs. But when we saw Marty Stewart, he called and said, "No, man, let's do country. We gotta do some country stuff." So that's how it came to be that we're here tonight doing this, and John playing bass, and with John, it's just a great playing with great musicians. So I've been playing this kind of music for 50 years, and here's one thing I never thought I would say in my life. Could you give me more monitor?
Is that what it is?
No, that isn't it. Here's the thing I never thought I would never be saying in my life. The first tune we're going to do is a Travis Tritt song. From 1991, it hit number 2 on the country Billboard. And John says some folks won't get the reference here because here's a quarter called Someone Who Cares. When's the last time, well, show of hands, when's the last time you saw a telephone booth?
In London.
So that's how we're going to start. Here we go. Charts and number 19 on the pop charts. It's been recorded by everyone, including Eddie Fisher and Patsy Cline for some variety. So here it is. This is called Anytime. You see, right?
Signing show up there. That was great. We just played. He was in for a couple hours up there.
Three hour gig.
Time goes by.
3 hour gig, and you want to pay nothing because we volunteered. It was a Slowpokes cruise in the car club up there, and I played up there. It's been 5 years. We've done it in a couple of years, and all the proceeds go to the Huff Foundation for kids' supplies for school. So we volunteered to do that. We're nice guys. So John keeps bugging me about Eddie Arnold, but I'm not Eddie Arnold.
Hank Williams.
So you can't do classic country without doing a Hank song. And the one we chose to do is I Can't Help It If I'm Still in Love with You. And Hank Williams wrote and recorded this in 51. I was 10. I remember when that was a hit. And it reached number two on the Billboard Country Singles Chart. And when he recorded the same recording session, also produced Hey Good Lookin', Howlin' at the Moon, and My Heart Would Know.
Wow, that's a good
of
session.
Those three, I know Hey Good Lookin'. So, little Hank Williams. And it goes something like this.
Something?
Well, it goes exactly like we were impressed.
I don't think Hank's done it this way.
I recommend that highly. The Wild Side of Life. this song. This is a great song. This song was first recorded by Jimmy Heap and the Melody Makers. And you wonder why it didn't go far. Hey, it's Jimmy Heap. God dang, I can't wait to hear old Jimmy. So that was 1951. But in 1952, a fellow by the name of Hank Snow got a hold of it, and his recording would stay 15 weeks at number one on the country charts. Old Jimmy Heap was going, God dang, I wish I'd done that. A couple of other Hank Snow hits that you might recognize are Now and Then There's a Fool Such as I. You know that one? And then John knows the other one.
I've Been Everywhere. A song I've done about six times in public and screwed up at least three times. At least twice on this stage.
He says, you know, it's such a flow of words. He says, if I miss one city, I'm screwed.
You miss one, you're pretty much screwed.
So this is a wild side of life. Something I'm wanting to tell you. alone with memories of you. And the kisses that you traded for my tears. No one will ever know how much I love you. And I pray that you be happy through the years. I didn't know God made honky tonk Truth be, it is the new San Antonio Rose, because Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, you all remember those guys?
Oh yeah.
This was one of many hits of Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys. San Antonio Rose was written as an instrumental in 1938. A couple of years later, the record company said, hey, Bob, write some lyrics to that. He said, okay, give me a few minutes. He did, and they called it the new San Antonio Rose. So if you don't know Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, they had he played fiddle, and they had two other fiddle players, right?
Like two fiddles.
Greedy Brothers sisters. And so it was more of a country swing, jazzy style, swing, big band style with country instrumentation. So his songs were, here are the songs he was popular for. The New San Antonio Rose, The Stars and Stripes on Iwo Jima, Smoke on the Water, Smoke on the Water, A Fire in the Sky. That wasn't Bob Wills.
It's easy to confuse him. It's easy to confuse Bob Wills and Deep Purple.
I
get them mixed up all the time. Doug's worth the price of admission, wouldn't you think?
And then, a steel guitar rag in 1950, Bob Wills had two number one hits with Ida Red Likes the Boogie.
I think when Doug was 11 years old, that was a pretty big year. I keep hearing 1950, 1951. That year made a pretty big impression on him.
Yeah, and he wrote Faded Love, whichever way it was happening. Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 1999. As founders. And we went to the Rock and Roll Hall Museum in Cleveland. Yeah, God, if you ever get a chance to do that, do it. It makes old Paul Allen's place pretty.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of weird. Have you ever seen the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony? It's kind of cool, but what they bring these guys out and they make them play again their hits, which it sounds kind of cool, but they haven't played them for a while. And so they sound, and you think about it, it's not like if you get inducted into the Football Hall of Fame, they make you go out and put on pads and knock each other around. They're all kind of out of shape by then, but it's... Sometimes it's cool to see these guys playing and singing, but sometimes it's kind of like, yeah, I think I would have left it back then. The Temptations don't look quite the same. They don't move quite as well either. But it's a fun show.
So the new San Antonio Rose and Slide's going to kick this off.
What? A little hint. This is the last song for Slide to be playing Slide on, so you better...
Can't we do this, Gene?
Gene.
he said, "Can the audience, do you mind if we try a song out on you? Because we have been asked to play El Paso at the Country Music Hall of Fame induction ceremonies for one Grady Wilson."
Grady Martin?
Grady Martin? Mm-hmm. No, that's guitar.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Grady Martin did the fabulous guitar work on the recording and was recently inducted to Country Music Hall of Fame. Felina of the song was named after a schoolmate of Marty Robbins, who was named Fidelio Miss Martinez. F-I-D-E-L, Fidelina, Fidelina, something like that.
When, so, she wasn't Felina?
She wasn't really Felina.
Oh, okay.
Felina sounds like an organic breakfast food. El Paso was written and recorded by Marty Robbins for his album, one of the great albums of all time, Gunfighter Ballads and Trail Songs.
That's a great album.
You seen that?
Marty Robbins. That's a great album. They probably got it at Crossroads.
It was released in September of 1959. He's from Glendale, Arizona. His brother worked at a gas station where a friend of mine worked. It was then released as a single October of 59 and reached number one on both the country music charts and the pop charts in 1960. In 1961, it won the Grammy for Best Country and Western Recording. So this is how we're going to try to do it.
I think Marty wore that very shirt on that album.
That's Marty's shirt right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Marty doesn't know what happened. Marty's dead.
One recording.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Dan of the Maritime would find me at Rose's Cantina. The music would play and Felina would blow. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. Strong for the Mexican maiden, I was in love, but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as a West Texas wind. Dashing and daring and drink he was sharing with him good Felina, the girl that I love. Challenge his right for the love of the queen. Down went his hand for the gun that he wore. My challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat. The handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor. Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shocked by the foul evil deed I had done. My mind as I stood there, I had but one chance and that was to run. Up to the back door of Roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. I found a good one, it looked like you could run, up on his back and away. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left. It's been so long since I've seen a maiden. My love is stronger than my fear of death. I My love is strong and it pushes me onward. Down off the hill to Foley there I go. Off to my right I see five mounted cowboys. Off to my left ride a dozen or more. Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's back door. Something is dreadfully wrong, for I feel a deep burning pain in my side. Though I am trying to stay in the saddle, I'm getting weary, unable to ride. But my love for the leader is strong, and I rise where I've fallen. Though I am weary, I can't stop to rest. I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle. I feel the bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Felina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for, one little kiss and Felina goodbye.